Hey guys, Paul from UltimateFatBurner.com here, and today I'm going to give you two quick tips on how to get more from your creatine monohydrate. I'll be right back in a couple seconds. Stick around. Hey, all right, welcome back. In this video, I'm going to give you two quick tips on how to get more from your creatine monohydrate. You'll find a link to the clinical studies that I use to confirm these tips in the description under this video. By all means, check them out. They are there, so you know I'm not just making this stuff up as I go along. All right, let's get right to it with tip number one. And it's all about getting more creatine into your muscles. More creatine in your muscles equals more ability for work and therefore a greater adaptive response and more gains. So how do you get more creatine into your muscles? Well, studies show that stacking it with certain ingredients can help. One study stacked it with sucrose, which is just simple sugar, and then a combination of sucrose and alpha-lipoic acid, or ALA, a nutritional supplement that enhances glucose uptake. So the study was conducted with three groups of participants. Group number one took 20 grams of creatine per day. Group number two took 20 grams of creatine per day, along with 100 grams of sucrose. And group number three took 20 grams per day of creatine, along with 100 grams per day of sucrose and 1,000 milligrams of alpha-lipoic acid. So what were the results? Well, the study showed that the group ingesting the alpha-lipoic acid along with their sucrose and creatine had significantly greater increase in phosphocreatine and total creatine. So the moral of the story is stacking your creatine with sucrose and ALA may get you better results from the supplement. If you want to try an experiment, do a 5-day loading phase with 20 grams of creatine monohydrate per day and stack it with 100 grams of sucrose and 1,000 milligrams of alpha-lipoic acid. After the 5-day loading cycle, you can go back to your 5 or 10 gram per day maintenance dose and see what, if any, changes you notice in your training. And of course, if you do this, please let us and our viewers know how it went for you in the comments below. Okay, so that's tip number one. So what's tip number two? Tip number two is to make sure you're taking plenty of whey protein when you take creatine. So one interesting study confirms this. This study was performed on three groups of people. One was a placebo group. Group number two was a group that got approximately 0.55 grams of whey protein per pound of body weight per day. In other words, a 200 pound person would be taking in almost 110 grams of whey protein per day. And the third group, they got 0.55 grams of whey protein per pound of body weight per day and 0.1 gram of kilogram per body weight per day of creatine monohydrate. In other words, a 200 pound person would be taking in 9 grams of creatine in addition to the whey protein. The study found that although not all strength measures were improved by supplementation, those who used the creatine whey protein combination had greater increases in lean tissue mass and bench press than those who supplemented with only whey protein or the placebo. All right, guys, there you have it. Two tips to get more out of your creatine monohydrate. I really hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, it would be great if you could give it a thumbs up, and if you think your friends would enjoy it, a share would be super cool as well. And of course, if you're not subscribed to this channel yet, I gotta ask you, why aren't you? All the cool kids are doing it. Seriously, it'd be awesome to have you on board. Thanks so much for watching. Appreciate your support, and I'll see you again very soon.